And welcome to the first ever vlog of Reubenhood. So I've recently started following a bunch of vlogs, which is basically a video blog for those of you who haven't heard, and thought it might be a kind of a fun little experiment to try. So the topic for my first vlog is art journaling, one of my favorite pastimes ever. If you're a friend of mine, you've probably heard me talk about art journaling. It's basically a really fun way to get creative, to get clear about what you want to do. Sometimes normal journaling can feel a little bit, you can get a little stuck doing it. It can feel a little intimidating for people who aren't writers and people who like to think a little bit more visually. So I really enjoy art journaling. For me, it's a way to get out my feelings in a really creative way. It's also a really good way to set goals and get clear about what you're wanting. So I'm going to show you a few little art journal pieces that I've created lately. So I have a lot of them, so one second. Okay, first, this is my art journal. Well, my first art journal. And so it's just little pieces of sparkly cupcakes. I love, can you see this? Here. Love, love, love sparkly cupcakes. They make everything better. I have the word aha moment because quite frequently when I'm journaling, I have these aha moments. Immerse yourself. A celebration. Feel the love. Positive feedback. Just lots of pretty, pretty things. So then we've got a few pages that I did during a... Oh, okay, my computer turned off. I'm really new at vlogging, so apologies in advance. But it's sort of about my breakup, so I traced my handprint, kind of like, this is where I am, right here, right now. Navigating change. I have a few of my, like, really inspirational quotes. Deep, embodied, authentic. And one of my favorite quotes, the most exciting, challenging, and significant relationship of all is the one you have with yourself. And if you find someone to love the you you love, well, that's just fabulous. And that's from Carrie Bradshaw of Sex and the City. So those are some of my moodier pages. And often I will watercolor, paint, and blend a few different colors together, and then I'll collage on top of it. And sometimes I'll write on like magazine pages or on top of the things that I'm collaging with. And then I'll watercolor on top of that over it. So it just gives it a really nice textured look. And then I've got a lot, where's the page? Oh, and then this is something that I've done recently. I loved this quote. So here's the page. And the quote is, "It is not revolutions and upheavals that clear the road to better days, but revelations and lavishness and someone's soul inspired ablaze." So I just thought that was really beautiful. And so I did like orange watercolor and then I tore up pieces of a black magazine and then I did a green watercolor background. So yeah, kind of fun. And then my other art journal is kind of a little different. I more use it for storage purposes, but I have one of my favorite quotes ever by Henry Miller on the cover. And it is, "Develop interest in life as you see it, in people, things, literature, music. The world is so rich, simply throbbing with treasures, beautiful souls, and interesting people. Forget yourself." I think that is so incredibly powerful. Yes, so that's my cover, and it's got this girl floating in a pool and looking very relaxed and all kinds of things. So, just like, I really like to sometimes, I'll journal on a piece of paper and then I'll cut up the lines and make like a cool shape with it. So these are all different lines that I journaled and then I just made them into like a little fan. And there's like sparkly butterfly stickers because, yeah, I mean, no explanation necessary, obviously. I also like to like layer paper and do little pages. So like, sorry, I haven't really gotten this whole thing down, but I'll add tissue paper to the pages and like little bag things. And so sometimes, like, it can be cool to stick something on the page, like a little bag like this, and keep some ephemera in there. Okay. Let's see. If there's anything. Some of my pages are really, like, light and fun, like, and sparkly and colorful, like this one. And others are a little darker, depending on my mood. And so another thing that could be really cool is to do sort of an art journal board about your dream career. So I created this like a year and a half ago, and it's actually the back of a Tory Burch shoebox. And I just think the pattern's really fun, and I like to save random little bits of things. But this sort of describes my idea. So I have feeling good, impact, make one, improve, connect, make fabulous your day job. I've got a little like a feather and a sparkly thing. Find your bliss, blogger, connect, improve, women who make beautiful things, healthy living, and reaching your potential is more than ideal. It's the ultimate goal. So. Yeah, it's my sparkly little collage, and I keep this near my bed, and it inspires me every day. And then finally, it can be kind of fun to do a vision board, like, in the beginning of a season. So I did this one in April, and this was right after my breakup and all kinds of craziness in my personal life. So I went on an art journaling and yoga retreat, and I made this fabulous thing. So here's the first part, and I love adding ribbons and anything that sparkles. So these were just things that I was looking to have more of in my life this spring. So I said, one of them is sisterhood is powerful. I feel like my girlfriends have been so incredible, and I'm so lucky to have them in my life. And when you go through a breakup, it's just solidified how important your friends are, particularly your ladies. Live your best life, trust your intuition 100%. That's something that I'm really working on. I think we all have that inner voice, but it's so easy to doubt it. So yeah, definitely something. Mingle creative ideas for unique gatherings. One thing I'm wanting to do more and more is not just do the typical everybody out at a bar thing. I want to do more unique things. So something that I'm working on. Girl time, artful blogging, the universe has my back, kind of becoming a little woo-woo, a little more hippie every day. That's cool. Show yourself some love, feel healthy, and I've got little cupcakes on either side of that, so I don't know what that says, but whatever. And then on the back, I have this girl doing a headstand, which is sort of in leopard print shorts. And so that kind of represents being a little more fearless and wild, and less overthinking. I have haute hippie, because that's like kind of how I want to describe my style now, I've decided. Everyone has a calling. Here we go. Got the guy from Tom's here, Blake Mizakowski or something like that. So freaking cool. Check out his book. He basically, for every pair of shoes you buy, and they're so cute, they give a pair to someone without shoes. And I recently did the Day Without Shoes Day, and it was really fun and cool. I've decided I'm a hippie at heart, so yeah. And then I just got like all kinds of things. Feel it to heal it. So yeah, this is my vision board. So that's a little bit about me and why I love art journaling so much. Please leave a comment below if you liked this video, if you like art journaling. Look forward to hearing from you.